What is going on, you guys? RG3Vlogs here. I'm bringing you guys a brand new video. Today's video is obviously check the calendar. It's Saturday. Today we're watching Spooky Scary Saturdays. You know, well, we're not watching it. We're reacting to the Spooky Scary videos. If you do not know what Spooky Scary Saturday is, I basically just already told you. It's that simple. I come on YouTube to react to spooky scary videos. The reason why I put air quotes on that is because sometimes they're not even spooky or scary. They're just plain out weird to me. I don't know. But yeah, keep a short intro today. So without further ado, first video. Alright guys, so this first animation is titled Happiness, and this was uploaded by Steve Cutts. And remember in the beginning when I said some of them are weird? Based off this thumbnail, I think this is gonna be a weird one to me. Only because it's like a rat driving a car. But, I don't know. A lot of rats. Damn, they're really packed in there. Damn. That's really how it'd be on Black Friday. I don't know if you've been to a store on Black Friday, but the arms flying everywhere. Was that the display TV? The one on the display? Wow. Oh. Happiness. Happy smile on your face. Damn, they got his tires like that? It's not happiness, dog. Damn. Now he's on some antidepressants, bruh. Pills wearing off already, bruh. Missing big toe. Did you guys see that? Why are you waiting? Just grab it there, bro. I mean, obviously, the thing is, like, all that stuff that he was doing, it doesn't get you happiness, but, I mean, what really does? Yeah, I don't know. Let's just move on. Alright, guys, so this next video is titled The Horror Short Film Kissed, and this is uploaded by Alter. You know who they are already, brother. Oh my god, I hate this music. You guys haven't been watching me for a while, you know that this weird ass music this played on another video in one of mine. It was on Crypt TV's the Looksee, that tall dude with no face, this with no eyes or whatever. Yeah.
Talk very much, dude.
My guy, she's dead.
That's just fine with me. Guess I'll be the one doing the talking.
Don't kiss a dead person, dog. I mean, I hope not. I mean, it is titled Kissed, so.
My, my. What big eyes you have, my dear. They told me they found you at the bottom of a lake. You drowned. Your lungs filled with the water and mud.
She wakes up, she's like, I drowned? That's good. I couldn't work there, dude. To be honest.
You know, you're one of the prettiest girls I've ever worked on. I've seen all different types of people come in here. Old people, young people, kids, even babies. People that are torn in half, all cut up, missing limbs. They took a lot of work. Not you. You're easy. Just a couple touch-ups and voila. You're done. I like you.
That's your first hint there, dog. Dude, she about to scream. She about to say something. No, 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 don't do that. You're that desperate, huh? That's good. I heard it like desperate, but he on another level. Kissing a dead person.
Let's get you cleaned up.
What do you mean get you cleaned up? You just put makeup on her.
Let's seal up those lips so you can't kiss and tell, darling. Hmm? Sweet dreams, beautiful.
Yep. See, if that was me, I would have known something was going down after the radio said and then shut off. I wouldn't be there. What am I talking about? I wouldn't even be working there, so it's like, I wouldn't be in that position. I couldn't see myself working there. Even before watching this video, I couldn't see myself working there because of that. No. No thanks. I'm cool. I don't need this poltergeist, dog. Scared me. I don't mess with them ghosts, dude. Alright guys, so this next animation is titled We're Watching You Animated, and this is uploaded by our friend Llama Art. You already know who he is, dog. We know who basically everybody that I react to, because it's all the same people. They just be having good videos, so...
I'm okay.
So I'm doing different style, brother. He's not telling the story? Or whoever tells the story?
Everything okay, ma'am?
What the hell?
Huh. Goddamn shoe. There's still people. It's a quiet neighborhood. Maybe I'm just exaggerating.
Can I help you, dog?
Is there something I can help you with, sir? Come on, man. You're seriously freaking me out.
Is that a kid?
Okay, alright, I get it. No one calls me on my birthday, so this is, I guess, what you decided to do instead? Listen, guys, I played enough Silent Hill, okay? This is nothing.
We're watching you.
What the hell?
You like to be seen.
That jawline, that was good.
There's no one here. What's happening?
Oh.
You like to be seen. What the fuck are you people talking about? Please be a dream. Please be a dream.
What?
How the hell did I get here? Where are those people? What were those people? Hello? Is anyone here?
The face. Oh no, don't do that. And yeah, let's move on to the next video. Alright guys, so this next short film, it's not an animation. I don't know why I got so far away from my mic. It's not an animation, this is called what? Title says, She Knows. Horror short film, and this was uploaded by Spencer Keller. My man, get a better last name. This that good production. A lot of blood on that car, dog. You might want to ditch the ride. And he goes back in it. Okay.
Be on the lookout. Police texts are looking for this 14-year-old girl, and they say could be in serious danger. She was last seen on January 27th. That's when a girl's parents say they last heard from their daughter.
It was a 14-year-old girl that you hit, brother.
The community held a prayer service praying for the girl's safe return.
Rage, intolerance, anger. It's what a lot of Americans are feeling across our nation right now. Right now is a moment we can all...
Hey, man.
What's up?
I was just calling to check in and see how you are.
I'm all right. How about you?
I'm good. I was just wondering where you put her. Where did you put her?
Oh, nah, bruh.
What do you mean?
Where did you put her? 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 Where did you put her?
Looks like I'm not calling anybody today or the next day because that's creeping me out, dog. That's gonna creep me out. Based off of the thumbnail I saw, I don't know if I'm probably gonna get scared, so I'm turning up my volume in my headphones right here. 220. Got that Mott's fruit snacks, brother. Or Mott's. What is it? Gummies? Fruit gummies? Bro, who watches freaking that show? That's good. After what you just encountered on the phone, you're gonna leave your lights off? Come on now. I would have had the whole house lit up. You're not waking up from that, huh? That one was louder. Uh-uh. No, there's a girl crying. I'm gone. Nope. No, thank you. Thanks for the offer, but I think I'm gonna just exit my building. My building? I don't know why I'm backing up. I have headphones on. I'm still gonna hear it loud. Oh, she's laughing now. Bro, what is that gonna do? I wanna know now. A bat to a freaking... I almost said extraterrestrial. What the fuck? I just woke up almost an hour ago, so it's like 7 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, 6:57. Hey. Did he open that? Or, oh. Word. There was no jump scare, but I still got scared, so, I'm not bad, Spencer Keller. Alright, guys, so this next animation is called Disturbing True Snapchat Stories Animated, and this was uploaded by Llama Arts once again. My guy, you're my friend, we text every day. Just kidding.
This happened a week ago. Okay. Up until a few days ago, I went to a small, local gym in my now previous New Jersey town called Black Bear Fitness. One day, I had the misfortune of running into some skinny, awkward, yet creepy-looking kid, probably 18 years old. He didn't look like he belonged in a gym at all. I had headphones in and I was doing my set when I heard him saying something to me, but it was muffled by the music. I was already annoyed with this kid, given that he was breaking an unwritten rule of the gym. Don't try to talk to somebody when they're doing their sets. I took my time finishing my set, and then took my headphones out to ask if he needed something. Then he started acting like I looked familiar, but right away I knew this kid was just trying some pathetic attempt at making friends. I assured him I didn't, but the kid wouldn't stop talking to me.
Hey, yo, back up.
Most of the conversation, but eventually he actually asked me for my Instagram and Snapchat.
Ew, he's wearing socks and sandals.
And for whatever reason, I gave them to him. Instead of just saying something like, buddy, I'm trying to work out, or I don't have social media. After I gave him my Snapchat and Instagram, however, I did kind of urge him to let me resume my workout. He finally seemed to get the message and walked away. Not without saying bye like 3 times, though.
I think that was his first friend ever.
That night, I got a snap on my phone saying, from Sean.
Sean.
I immediately sighed and said, oh no. Just wondering why the hell the kid would snap me. I opened the snap.
Ew.
And the kid was in a creepy, weird pose. Face way too close to the camera, with his head resting in his hand and a half smile on his face. The text over the picture was, hey, with 2 Y's. I muttered the words, what the fuck? For the record, I'm a guy, which made this even more weird. My thought process was, I've had enough of this loser already. I'm gonna remove him and make it clear I don't want to talk if I see him at the gym again. And so I did. I removed him minutes after he sent that snap. I'm sure not even a minute later, again, a message popped up on my phone. Saying Snapchat from Sean. I waited a few minutes before opening it. This one was even creepier. Now the kid was sitting up on his bed, no smile, more of a surprised, angry expression. The text over the image said, why did you remove me? Now I went as far as to block him, meaning he couldn't snap me anymore. And that was that. I threw my phone on the desk and sighed out of relief. Half an hour later, my phone goes off, saying Sean added you as a friend, and then Snapchat from Sean. He actually made a new account.
Bruh.
I open the snap.
He desperate.
It was a picture of my front lawn. The text over it, answer me, bitch. The first thing I could think of was, how did he find my address? Then I realized, Snapchat made that new map feature that lets you see where your friends are. Somehow,
yeah, I got my location turned off on Snapchat. Ain't nobody gonna come up unannounced,
bro. I shut the window and the blinds and started considering calling 911. It was the sound of taps on the window. I took a deep breath, and with one swift motion, I pulled up the blind and the window at the same time and pulled the kid into my room by his neck.
Yes, sir!
I punched him in the face a few times before he was out cold.
Now 1-2 wombo combo.
Now I called 911. By the time they arrived, he was awake, cursing me out, promising he'd be back and kill me. The cops heard it all. I didn't even have to make a case. The kid was an idiot. Luckily, the timing of this worked out well, because I just moved a couple days ago out of state. Only thing that worries me, I don't want to have to make a new Snapchat account, but anytime somebody new adds me on the app, I'll never know if it's secretly that Sean...
What kind of name? Binary code and shit with your ones and zeros? Pretty cool. Alright guys, so for this last animation, yes sir, you heard me right, last animation, we have 6 videos today. Special day, we have that rare 6th animation. But this one's titled A Disturbing True Snapchat Story 2 Animated, and this is also obviously uploaded by Lawnmower, since it's Story 2 Snapchat Horror Disturbing. Yep.
This is a short but terrifying story of something that happened when I was Snapchatting a friend. I'm pretty young, I'm only 13, still in middle school.
That's not the dude we just saw, dude.
Had just recently started snapping me selfie pictures, and we started messaging each other for a few nights. One night when I was watching TV, she sent me a snap of herself laying in her bed without a caption. I sent a message saying, "What's up?" She sent another identical picture, this time with a caption saying, "Not much, you?" She set the timer to 10 seconds, so it gave me plenty of time to analyze the picture, including her bedroom in the background, and the dark outline of a person standing by her window. I quickly sent a response message, saying, "Is that your brother by the window?" She sent another identical snap, this time captioned, "What do you mean?" In this picture, the figure at the window was closer, and I could see a hand pressed up against the glass.
How do you not see that,
bro? I closed the snap before the timer even ran out so I could tell her quicker. I said, "There's somebody at your window, turn around." She opened my snap almost immediately, and then I didn't hear from her again on the app. I grew more and more worried as the minutes passed. I texted her a few times to no avail. I tried calling her a few times to no avail as well. I didn't know her house phone number, otherwise I would have called her parents. It wasn't until midnight when I was already laying in bed that she finally texted me back. She explained the whole situation. As soon as she looked at her window and saw the person standing there, she screamed. And that caused the person, who turned out to be a 20-something-year-old man, to open the window and jump into the room. From there, she ran to her
rain
parents'
boots,
room and woke her dad, who went to her room to find nothing but an open window. It wasn't exactly a personal story of mine, but it freaks me out nonetheless, knowing that the only thing that saved my friend from whatever could have happened was the fact that I was able to see the window through her selfies, unbeknownst to the creeper at her window.
See, that's why you need to pay attention. You know, this, before I even send a picture on Snapchat to someone, I look at the picture I just took. You could easily saw, "Yo, what you doing right there, dog?" But, yeah, I don't know. Some people are just dumb and don't even look, so I guess I'm the only smart one here. And also, I don't know, I have a screen on my window. You know how, like, some windows, they just open up, and he just jumped in, so there's no screen. Unless, I mean, he could have removed... You want to do something else at once? I don't know. That's going to be it for today, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. This was a good Spooky Scary Saturdays video. It was a lot of fun recording this one today. We got that rare 6th animation. It's honestly crazy. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe if not already done so. Have a great day. Hopefully I made yours. If today was your birthday, then have a happy birthday. And peace out.